Hi Ranjini, so here we are at Heather Farms. There's the office and we are in the club room. There is usually a sandwich board here that the city put out for us that says Music Together. Okay, so they have usually turned on the heating for us and the lights, and they're all on this wall. So you need these two switches for the lullaby, and you also need these two. There are four sets of lights on this ceiling. Here is the thermostat, which you can set to your own convenience. They've usually put it on already, and it's usually quite warm. Okay, so we have a lot of storage cabinets here. The ones that the city always have open for us are letter B and letter L. Now I cannot open or close, unlock or lock them, so I have to put this on while we're in class so that the kids don't get in. I also put a lock over the sink here because that doesn't have a lock or it's broken or something, and then I put one here as well because under this sink it's broken or something. Anyway, right, so in L is most of the instruments. There's name tags, which you don't use anymore, stretchy bands, castanets, sticks coming in up here, they're on the side right now, shakers, bells, triangles, which almost no other location has, and just a box of books, tissues. This is our wet box up here. It's actually a labeled wet box there with, you know, all the stuff. And then this sound bar, which goes at the front of, I'm just packing up now, it goes at the front here. Okay, so that is a lot of goodies in there. Oh, and red wrist bells, yes, they are in this black bag there. Okay, I always put the trash and the recycling up, otherwise the kids will get into it. People usually come through this door that we came through. There is this other door, which of course we can open, but cannot be opened from the outside. So sometimes people are struggling to get in here, and we either have to open the door for them or gesticulate them to go around. This is a shaded place. This is great for leaving strollers outside. Please don't let people bring strollers inside. I don't let them, and I don't want to start that precedence, and also it takes up space and distracts kids. They can leave their stroller here where they can see everything and just bring in whatever they need. All right, around this side, in the other cabinet, which again I have to lock during class because there's no other way to lock it, there's lots of space in here. So in here is going to go my scarves, because I finished with those today. And then on top of that would go the jam box, which is up there at the moment, and also tennis balls. We use that and roll that little ball, but you know, whatever you want to use it for. There's some bongos, which don't fit in anything else. And then there are these little round mats, which I set in a circle on the floor to give people an idea of where to sit. And because it's fun, people like to choose their colors and so on. Okay, we have nothing to do with these two closets. There is no piano here. So you're entirely dependent on what you bring. I usually bring my ukulele. And there are two bathrooms here. Try to keep them closed. If they are closed, the kids usually cannot get in. But if they're not closed, the kids like to play with the doors and open them up. Okay, parking, you can park here while you unload, and then you just need to go about 50 feet away for your permanent parking. Well, if you have any trouble, you can always ask in the office over there. There's Heidi and Kelsey, and they are very helpful. I think at this time you have just two people in the 9:15, which is not good, but we're gonna try and run it anyway. And then you have 10 people in the 10:15. Materials. I need to leave you materials because I won't be here again before next Tuesday. So I'm gonna leave them in this thing here, okay? And everybody has to pay a $45 fee because with the city classes, the people pay the city for the classes and they pay Music Together for the materials, which is $45. It can be paid in cash or check made out to me, or it can be paid on my website under the tab store, where it says Walnut Creek City Materials Fee. If people claim that they don't know about this and they've already paid the city and blah, 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 which people always do, you can mention that it's in the city description of the class when they sign up. It's in the confirmation that they get from the city, and it's in the welcome email that I have sent them. So there's no excuse for not paying, although often it takes me like till week 6 or 7 to actually get $45 from every single person in the class. Okay, thanks. It's a kind of cool room acoustically, and everything's here. One last thing, it's a shoes off facility as far as I'm concerned. So parents put their shoes up on the side. Do not let them leave backpacks and shoes and so on the floor. It is a tripping hazard. It takes up the space and is very distracting for all the other kids. There's plenty of space for parents to put their things up and out of the way. Bye-bye.